Last week, several key players in the auto industry, from GM's Mary Barra to Tesla's Elon Musk, have expressed concerns about the growth prospects and viability of the EV market. Just a few years ago, GM was boldly stating that they would build 100,000 EVs in the second half of 2023 and another 400,000 by the first half of 2024. Now they're not so sure. Recently, GM announced that it is abandoning those targets. And what's the reason behind it? Well, in the words of GM CEO Mary Barra, as we get further into the transition of EVs, it's a bit bumpy. And that basically means that many automakers are struggling with the transition to EVs because of profitability and really a tight economic environment. So hello everyone, my name is Mark Weich. Thanks for checking out this video on cleanearth.io. Before I continue, if you haven't already, please hit that like and subscribe button. By doing that, you're really helping us to grow our platform as well as improve what we do here, and we simply appreciate it. GM isn't the only one with problems. Mercedes-Benz has resorted to slashing prices on their electric vehicle models in order to move them off lots, saying this is a pretty brutal space. Mercedes-Benz has recently reported a nearly 7% drop in operating profit, falling to 4.8 billion euros in the third quarter of this year. The company's chief financial officer, Harald Wilhelm, revealed some serious challenges overshadowing the electric vehicle market. So Wilhelm points to competition and supply chain disruption as factors impacting the bottom line as it relates to EVs, even suggesting that the current state of the market may not be fully sustainable for everyone involved. What he's saying is that some automakers may not be viable in the EV industry. He hasn't made specific references, but certainly he believes that not everyone is going to survive as an EV maker or even transitioning to EVs. With EV sales surging in Europe and China, European automakers in particular are really struggling. And this is due to increased competition from Chinese automakers like BYD, XPeng, and NIO. These automakers are steadily gaining share, and it has gone so far as prompting an investigation by the EU into EV subsidies for automakers by the Chinese government. Now, the EU is considering implementing tariffs on EVs implemented into Europe, and that's a hotly sort of debated topic right now in Europe. Let me know what you think about that. Is that a wise play by the European Union? Is that a necessary play to really sort of stem the increasing competitiveness and dominance of the Chinese automakers, especially as it relates to EVs in the European market? Even Tesla, the longtime leader in EVs, is voicing concerns about the economic environment that could lead to reduced EV demand. Now, there are some other challenges. So, for potential buyers, cost remains a significant factor and barrier to purchasing EVs. Even with the discounts and markdowns, EVs are not flying off dealer lots as expected. And adding to this are concerns about EV charging infrastructure and how an electric car really fits the everyday lives of most consumers. So, are these challenges a temporary setback or a deeper issue within the EV industry? The current business environment for EV, as well as economic conditions, are also forcing other automakers to rethink their strategies. So Ford, Honda, and other manufacturers are also rethinking their EV strategies, adjusting production targets, and in some cases, terminating plans for affordable electric cars. Now, from a forward-looking perspective, some car makers like Volvo are optimistic. They're planning to sell only electric cars by 2030. And the same holds true for Nissan in Europe, where they will sell only electric cars in Europe by 2030. Now, discussing sentiment from industry leaders like Mercedes-Benz, they suggest that the EV market needs to find more stable ground if it is to sustain its current pace. So it's clear that the EV market is evolving, but not without some significant challenges. Now, while this does not negate the potential for long-term success of EVs, it is a wake-up call for automakers and investors that this is not going to be an easy road. So what do you think about this shift in strategy and rethink of the EV business for automakers? Do you think there are some opportunities, or do you think that it's simply not viable for several automakers? And who might they be? Also, are these changes a real concern for the future of EVs in the near term? So if there are automakers who are getting out of the affordable EV business, does that potentially impact the adoption of EVs broadly? And how is this something that can be addressed in terms of making sure that automakers do remain committed to producing affordable EVs as well as EVs that people want? So leave your comments and your questions in the comment section below. And once again, thanks for checking out this video. While you're still here, please make sure you hit that like and subscribe button. We'll see you in the next one soon. Thanks for watching.